use some rain. I'm seeing that people are just using kayaks instead. Yeah. That's about the only thing you can launch these days.
Absolutely. And, you know, October tends to be one of our drier months, climatologically speaking, unless we have tropical system moving in, bringing us some rain. But we're not going to have the rain from Matthew. We could use a little bit of that rain, but this is a devastating storm. Here's a look at Matthew right now as it is churning just to the north of Cuba. Here's a track of Matthew as it curves towards the Bahamas, and look how close it's going to come to that shore in Florida before curving out to sea just to the south of Charleston by Saturday. One, this is a slow-moving storm. Two, the new track, this is a track that came out while you were sleeping last night, is now being pushed a little bit further to the west, and that's going to have some big implications along the Florida coastline. Notice here, it's starting anywhere late Thursday afternoon is when it begins to move towards Florida, through Friday early morning, and then curving out to sea by Saturday early morning. They could feel hurricane force winds along the coastline for anywhere from Miami all the way to Jacksonville. Here's a look at the rainfall that we could potentially be seeing with this storm. Thursday at 1 o'clock. Keep in mind though, Florida is going to be located on the western side of this hurricane. It's the eastern side of the hurricane that produces the most significant rainfall. So if there is any silver lining in this, it's that we will not see as significant of rainfall totals as we potentially could if this storm was it had a different placement. So as it moves up the shore, we are still going to see quite a bit of rain, but I think this is going to be a big wind event, especially for folks along the coast, anywhere from Miami to Charleston. Still keeping an eye, if this storm actually makes landfall, there will be a lot of tracking going on between now and Saturday, but I can pretty much tell you though that we're going to see very little threat from Matthew right here in central Alabama. In contrast, a bit of a pleasant start this morning, and a nice forecast is shaping up for us here today. 62 currently in Gadsden, that's comfortable. Same with 66 in Coleman. A little bit more mild from Birmingham to Tuscaloosa and Hamilton. The places that were a touch cooler yesterday seem to be our more milder locations this morning. And kind of switching gears, the places that were a little more mild yesterday are seeing some cooler, drier air on this early Wednesday morning. Let me break down your hour-by-hour forecast. We're staying in the 60s, right around 70 by 7 a.m. 9 o'clock temperatures with ample sunshine, lower 70s by that 9 o'clock hour. As we near lunch, about 80s. And then afternoon highs today, again in the upper 80s. We hit 88 yesterday. We didn't hit 90 here in Birmingham, so my promise has been kept, and I expect that to continue through the rest of the week. We'll actually see those temperatures backing off just a touch as we move into the weekend. Not only will the afternoon highs be backing off, but those morning lows could be dipping into the upper 40s, a true taste of fall, just in time for the Columbus Day holiday on Monday. And that is a look at your storm track 7-day forecast. Art.